Students, in my this video we will come to know about how does a particle is moving in a plane and what is the displacement, what is the equation of motion associated with that particle when it is moving in a plane, and what is the equation of path associated with that particle, right? So to start with, let us consider we are having two coordinate axes, x and y, since we are talking about that particle is moving in a plane, right? Let O is the origin, and initially the particle is at position A having position vector r1. As I have already explained this displacement vector, but still again I am explaining this. And let after time t2, it was at time t1 at A, and at time t2 it reaches to B having position vector r2, right? In that case, that AB will represent the displacement vector, which is given by r2 minus r1 as already been explained, right? Now if r1 vector is represented as xi cap plus yj cap, and r2 vector is represented as, suppose we represent it is r1, so we represent it as x1 and y1, and similarly r2 vector is represented as x2 I cap plus y2 j cap, where x1 y1 be the coordinates of the particle associated when it is at position A, and x2 y2 are the coordinate associated with the particle when it is at position B. So in that case, if I want to find out the displacement AB vector, which is given by r2 vector minus r1 vector, right? r2 minus r1, how we calculate it? By using triangle of vector addition, which is this r1 plus this AB is equal to r2. So from that we can find out AB is equal to r2 minus r1. Now r2 is what? This is x2 I cap plus y2 j cap minus this is x1 I cap plus y1 j cap. So we can get the value of AB is equal to x2 minus x1 I cap plus y2 minus y1 j cap. So this is the displacement vector associated with the particle when it is moving in the xy plane. Now to find out velocity, if we want to find out velocity, in that case velocity is equal to displacement upon time, and we know that displacement is given by r2 vector minus r1 vector divided by t2 minus t1. Since at time t1 the position of the particle is r1, and at t2 the position of the particle is r2, so v velocity vector is represented as r2 vector minus r1 vector upon t2 minus t1. So this is the velocity associated with the particle when it is moving in a plane. So we get the relation velocity is equal to v, which is equal to r2 minus r1 by t2 minus t1. Now let us find out the equation of motion of the object. So equation of motion, in that case we will simplify this expression as, from this expression we can write it as r2 minus r1 is equal to v vector t2 minus t1, right? So in that case, if we want to simplify, let us consider that at time t is equal to 0, initially the particle is at position such that its position vector is r, right? R naught, suppose, initially, and it is having coordinates x naught and y naught. And at time t2, let t1 is equal to t is equal to 0, and at time t2 is equal to t, right? In that case, let the particle having position vector r having coordinate x and y. So in that case, the above relation could be written as r vector minus r naught vector is equal to v vector t minus 0, since t2 is equal to t and t1 is equal to 0. So r vector is equal to r naught plus v t. Fine. Now we know that r can be represented as xi yj, right? So r can be represented as xi cap plus yj cap. R naught can be represented as x naught I cap plus y naught j cap. Similarly, v can be represented as vx I cap plus vy j cap, where vx and vy are the component velocities of the particle in respective x and y axis. As v magnitude, if we want to calculate, that will come out to be root of vx square plus vy square. So putting these values in this expression, r is equal to xi cap plus yj cap is equal to r naught is equal to x naught I cap plus y naught j cap plus v can be written as vx I cap plus vy j cap into t. So assuming that the I and j component coordinates on both sides are equal, so we can write here x is equal to x naught, right? X is equal to x naught, and this is vx plus vxt. Similarly, y component can be written as y naught plus vyt. So these two equations represent the equation of motion of the particle in x-axis and in y-axis. Now let us have a look how to find out the equation of path. From the equation this one, we can find out time t, which comes out to be x minus x naught divided by vx. So putting t here, we will get y is equal to y naught plus vy into, so vx will come down, and this is x minus x naught. So what does it represent? It represents y is equal to mx plus c, where m is the slope represented by this. This is the x component and this is the intercept. So basically this is the equation of straight line. So the graph, if we want to plot, so that would be like this is y naught, y naught. So equation will be a straight line having slope equal to vy by vx and intercept equal to y naught. So it means that in if a body is moving with uniform velocity in plane, so its equation of path will be a straight line.